YouTube, it's Ever Brittany Tin here, updating you guys with a new video. Today's video is going to be a little bit more serious than my typical love and hip hop or, you know, my opinionated videos. This video is about something that is very personal to me, and I've attempted to film this video about 3 or 4 times at this point. So let me give you a heads up. If you see like something sparkling, it's glitter, because I tried to do like the glitter thing, but glitter and tears don't mix. So this is like, I had to redo my face. My hair was not working with me. It's just a mess. And, you know, I really feel like it was a moment of me trying to back out of doing this video because it's so personal. And I'm typically not someone who likes to tell my business. Now, in the past I was, if you know me from like college and stuff, I was mouth almighty. But due to certain lessons in life, I've become very private. There's people who were present in my life while this was all going on and may not know all the details that I'm probably going to share with you all today. But things that happen to you are bigger than you, and you have to share your testimony because you don't know who is going through it and may not be as strong as you were to get through it. And they may need, you know, to hear somebody's story so that they understand that, you know, you're not broken, you're not weak, this is what's going on, and it's okay to share your story, and you're gonna get through it. You are. So I was diagnosed with lupus in July of 2015. I'm coming up this year on 2 years of being diagnosed. However, I feel like I've had the disease for a very long time, and, you know, we just didn't know what it was. So background, lupus is an autoimmune disease, and I know, that's scary. That's scary because usually when you hear about autoimmune disease, you're thinking of HIV, you're thinking of AIDS. It's nothing like that. My disease, lupus, actually attacks the good cells. So typically what your immune system is supposed to do is attack the bad cells. Somebody cough on you, got germs, your immune system goes into superwoman mode and it's supposed to beat them up so, you know, you don't get severely ill. Well, my cells are superwoman and they're beating up the good cells, which is not good. It can cause major harm with your body. It can attack your joints. It can attack your skin. It can attack major organs as well. And, you know, living with it is tough. I'm not going to lie to you. It's not easy to deal with some of the symptoms, but I'm here. I'm strong and, you know, I'm going to tell you my story. So more than 90% of lupus sufferers are women, mostly between the childbearing ages of like 15 to 44. Women of color are 2 times as likely to have lupus. And it is the leading cause of premature cardiovascular disease, kidney disease, and strokes among women. And it can range from mild symptoms to severe. So there's different stages, and I'll get into more depth about that in a minute. So the different types, there is the discoid lupus, and I always jack the word up, but it's like erythematosus. And that's like the skin rash. So usually they call it like the butterfly rash, where you're like breaking out all of your forehead and your face. Then there's subacute cutaneous lupus, and that's when you have like open sores in your body. And sometimes that happens like when you're in the sun. And then there's drug-induced lupus. I don't know too much about that, but from what I understand, it's like specific drugs sometimes can trigger it. I personally feel like you probably already had it and then you had like a reaction to it and it just starts happening. Neonatal lupus is a rare type that affects newborns, and that makes me super nervous as someone who wants to have children one day, because obviously you don't want to even think about how you could possibly impact your child. And you're obviously, like, as a mother, you wouldn't want to harm your child in any kind of way, but this is not something that I can control. And, you know, I pray. I don't know if you guys are Christians, but I am. And, you know, pray, or if you have, you know, other beliefs, just sending positive vibes that just does not happen. And then there's the type that I have, systemic lupus erythematosus. And that is when the disease kind of, you always have it, but there's things called flare-ups where the symptoms get extremely worse. And for me, when it's really, really bad, it's to the point where I can't do anything. Everything hurts. All are super serious. All of them require treatment. I know me, I have had a rheumatologist since I was diagnosed. She actually diagnosed me when I was in the hospital, but I will get to that story in a minute. And I usually go to the doctor about, I'm doing really well now, so she spaced it out like 5 months. When I first was diagnosed, I was going like every 2, 3 months. I go to the rheumatologist, she does blood work to see how my disease levels are, how I'm feeling, and she will base, my medications off of what I need at that time. How is it diagnosed? Okay, typically you need to get blood work done. I have seen people find out their diagnosis and it took a long time for them to find out because they were going to their PCP and it was just blood work and different testing. Mine, we found out within 2 weeks of me going to the hospital, but my case was like really severe. So everything I needed to get done, they pretty much did it in like 4 days because of the extreme pain I was in. They also can do it with a skin biopsy where they look at your skin under a microscope. They can do a kidney biopsy, looking at tissues from your kidneys. But typically they use the ANA test, which is an anti-nuclear test, which is what I had done. And when you get the results back, that's when you know if you have the diagnosis of lupus or not. So that's some background just about the disease in general. And now I'm gonna tell you guys my story. So, like I said, I was diagnosed with lupus in July of 2015. But I honestly believe I've had it probably my whole life, but maybe something happened in July for me to trigger it. Actually, I do think something happened in July to trigger it, and I'll get to that. So, like I said, I was pretty decent kid growing up, I will say when I was in college, I would get sick like really bad at least once a year, but we didn't know what it was. Nothing too crazy. Like I was like, okay, I would say even after college, I would get sick like once a year. Nothing too alarming for me to feel like, oh, I'm so sick or something until June of 2015. So all of a sudden, it was like maybe the second week of June, I woke up regular day and could barely move my legs. Like literally woke up and was like, okay, like I was struggling. At the time, I had just started like trying to work back out. So I really attributed it to that and was like, I'm sore. Okay, whatever. So I go on about my business. I'm going to work in pain, and it was just my legs. Cool, a week goes by, the soreness moves, y'all. Like literally moves body parts. It started with my left arm, then it like traveled to my right arm, and then it was only in my right leg. And it was like a dance, like going around my body with pain and stiffness. My knees were swollen. Again, I'm thinking, okay, because I was still trying to work out, like, but I wasn't like hard, but it was like walking around the park or something like that. And I'm like, okay, like what's going on? I talked to my mom about it. And my mom, being a mom, was like, maybe you should go to urgent care, da 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 da. Me being young and dumb, I was like, nah, girl. At the time, I had just signed on to start having my house built, and I had a team member who was out of the office a lot, so I was racking up OT trying to get her work done. So I was hustling. I was like, nah, girl, I gotta get this. I gotta da 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 da. Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time for that.
Ain't nobody got time for that.
Until I literally could not walk. Like, it got so bad to a point where I have a job where we can work from home a lot. I had to like tell my boss, like, yo, I can't. Like, and I lived on a third floor of an apartment and I had a dog, not the dog I have now, my baby Maddie. She passed away like a year ago, but I had a dog and I was like, I could barely walk her. Like, it was crazy. My little sister had to come and walk my dog because it was just so bad. And my mom is like, girl, you really think you just sore from the gym? I'm like, yeah, girl, like, whatever, But I'll never forget it. It became too unbearable at one point. So I remember it was a Wednesday and I was working from home, again, hustling. And I still worked my OT that day. Ain't that a mess? I literally worked until like 5 o'clock. I go in at like 6. So it was like almost a 12-hour day. And I'm barely eating, barely going to the bathroom because it hurts. You know, I finally willed myself to be like, okay, this is crazy, girl. And the hospital was like literally up the street from my apartment at the time. Like, this was just ridiculous. So I finally had to put myself to the side and was like, okay. Oh, and mind you, I had already self-diagnosed myself thanks to WebMD. I thought I had early onset arthritis that I self-diagnosed. So I had my mom bring over like icy hot and stuff. Mind y'all, this stuff ain't even working. But in my mind, I'm like, all right, fine, whatever. So I don't know how I got the strength, but I got downstairs from the third floor, made it to my little Nissan Altima, and in all the pain in the world, drove myself down the street to the hospital, parked in the ER, went to the emergency room, and waited for like 5 hours to be seen. Worst hospital experience of my life, side note. Like, literally, they had one girl there at the reception desk, one girl doing like the intake. Mama, they caught pizza. They was eating. I'm like, it is sick people in here. It was just absolutely crazy. It was like the worst emergency room experience I've ever had in my life. I'm in pain the entire time. But I wasn't complaining too much because I was just sitting. It wasn't like I had to wait, walking up or whatever. I finally, mind you, my mom is doing the mom thing, blowing up my phone. You know how moms get, like, overly paranoid for no reason. My mom is blowing my phone up, y'all. Like, I'm like, yo, girl, I'm good. Like, I'm in the emergency room. She's like, uh-huh. Yeah, okay, call me. Because I'm like, Mom, I'm fine. You know, I get back, finally get back to the back. And at some point, I wasn't texting my mom back. And she was getting even more crazy. I found this out later. She was, like, even getting more frantic or whatever at that point. So I get to the back. And I'm talking to a nurse, and, you know, she's agreeing with me. She's like, yeah, you probably just got, like, some early onset arthritis. Let me tell you, girl, you need to get Tylenol arthritis, da-da-da-da. She's like, I'm so sorry, remove it slow. But basically was trying to say, like, my situation wasn't as serious as everybody else's, so this is why you kind of had to wait. I'm sitting here like, I agree. I just want y'all to write me a prescription for something strong so I can, you know, because it was hard to sleep as well because I was in so much pain. I'm like, all right, cool, girl, whatever. She's like, well, just so you know, we got something on the bus. I'm going to do some blood work on you. I'm going to take you to, I guess it's a CT machine. Like, you lay on your back and it's not an MRI. Don't have me lying, y'all. I don't know. But anyway, basically, like, they did, like, a little x-ray thing on my body. I had to lay down. And you went in and out, in and out. Mind you, again, my mother is blowing my phone up. I'm not responding. So, because I'm thinking she's overreacting. I'm like, I'm going to be home. I'm in the back now. I ain't even thinking about it. So the nurse disappears for like 30 minutes. I'm sitting there chilling because they was running all the tests, of course. So I'm sitting there chilling, whatever. I look up and here's my mother and my little sister like on a mission. Y'all know how mamas get. Y'all know how mamas get. She is like, Brittany, you wasn't responding, da-da-da-da. I'm like, my, y'all tripping, whatever. She was like, well, we're here. You know, we'll probably take Madison because you've been having a hard time walking her. Anyway, soon as my mom and my sister sit down, the nurse comes back and she's frantic. I'm like, girl, like, what happened? She was like, we got to get you to a room right now. I'm like, for some arthritis, girl. No. Like, she's like, it's not that. Like, I'm sitting here like, okay. She was like, look, we just took your blood work. Your white blood cell count is so low. You're neutropenic. I'm like, girl, like, huh? Neutro what? Like, I don't even know what she's talking about. And of course, my mother is, I don't know about y'all, mama, but somehow my mother has a doctorate degree. She's a dentist. She's a nurse. She's a lawyer. She's a personal trainer. She does it all. I don't know, just my mom. So my mom is already like freaking out, like, okay, so what's wrong? Da-da-da-da-da. I'm sitting here like, okay, but I still need the definition. Like, what are you talking about? She's like, your white blood cell count is abnormally low. She was like, you can't leave. We have to keep you. And I'm sitting here like, for some leg pain, lady, like, I just want the pills to go home. And she's like, nah, you're not going home. She's like, we can't let you go till we figure out what this is because you will mess around and be out of here. Like, check out of here. I'm like, oh, okay. You know, whatever. So I get admitted. And that night, like, I forgot her name, but the nurse was like on some rules. Like, I couldn't have fresh flowers in my room. I couldn't eat a lot. Like, I was eating like soup. I still have not eaten soup in like 2 years because that was all they gave me while I was in the hospital. I couldn't have like nothing. She was like, no, girl, sure won't. So I get admitted. Of course, my mother is still freaking out, looking up everything that it could be. We don't know. And over the next 4 days, I was poked and prodded more times than I'd like to count. I mean, I went to go see, I think it's a gastroenteritis, where they put me to sleep and put like a tube down my stomach. I had inflammation in my stomach. And that was because I was popping Tylenols and stuff, like regular Tylenols, thinking that I could alleviate the pain. And it did, but not like, it didn't take it away or anything, but it helped so I could like get up and go to the bathroom and walk my dog. But it was crazy. Like, I mean, it was a long 4 days. And during that period, you know, we found out that my kidney functioning was extremely low. Like, I should have been on dialysis. Again, things that, like, what do you mean? Like, I'm 25 years old and you want to put me on dialysis? Like, what is going on? It was a very, very tough time for my family. I remember my grandmother and my grandfather coming to the hospital. Like, everybody's scared because we didn't know. And it's very scary to feel like you don't even, you're not even feeling the magnitude of the pain going on in your body. Again, I'm telling y'all, all I felt was soreness and stiffness in my joints, and it's way deeper than that. Way, way deeper than that. Eventually, the main doctor I was seeing, he's the one that was like, we gotta keep, everybody was coming in doing all types of work. Eventually, he had a rheumatologist come in. Oh, Lord, I want you guys to get the story, so I'm really trying to pull it together. But eventually, a rheumatologist came in and talked to us. And she's still my rheumatologist to this day. She's very kind, very sweet lady. And, you know, she just kind of broke it down and was like, I'm going to be honest with you. I think you have lupus. Now, all I knew about lupus is that Toni Braxton had it, y'all. I didn't know what it was. I'm looking at her like, oh my God, am I gonna die? Like, it was, because all I knew was I'm a huge fan of the Braxtons, is how at least every year Toni gets like really, really sick. And so I'm sitting here like, oh my God, like what what's going on? And of course my mom, you know, as soon as she said it, my mother was on, you know, using her doctorate to figure out everything about the disease. And, you know, she kind of explained it for me, but I really didn't hear much of what she was saying because I was just trying to figure out at the time, like, how did this happen? Like I said, I was 25 years old at the prime. Like, I had a great career. I was making money. I had just graduated. Like, I had just graduated from grad school, like, a month before. I graduated in May with my master's. So I'm sitting here like, what's going on? What happened? I felt like a zombie. And, you know, once they pretty much had an idea of what it was, she put me on prednisone at the time, which was just a steroid, which I still hate to this day. But she put me on prednisone, and as much as I hate it, y'all, maybe about a week later, I felt like my old self again. It was crazy to me. So anyway, this particular doctor was like, you know what, this is what I think it is. I want y'all to call my office. I'm going to run this test. It was the ANA test. She was like, and so you'll come see me and, you know, we'll go over the results and everything. Those 2 weeks were longer than that 4-day hospital stay, because the whole time I'm like, what does this mean? Like, how is this going to impact my life? Of course, you see all the horror stories. You see the people who it has attacked, all their major organs. I hear stories of people who passed away trying to fight this disease. And I'm sitting here like, I have so much life to live. I'm like, I was single at the time, and I'm like, I haven't even met somebody who could be my husband. Am I going to be able to have kids? Like, I'm immediately freaking out. And, you know, my mom did her best to try to keep me calm. Like, you know, just chill. We're going to fight this. You know, we're, and my whole family was so supportive. I'm very, very blessed. My family was extremely supportive, of course. Came by my apartment, made sure I had food. My mom, actually, her and my little sister just took my dog, you know, at the time to try to keep her, you know, walked and all that stuff, because I couldn't do all of that. Again, I'm thankful for my coworkers. My boss allowed me to work from home. Even my part-time job was super kind to me, and, you know, people took my shifts because it was part-time, so people took my shifts, didn't complain. So I was very blessed that, you know, my circle was able to function and help me, because if they didn't, you know, I don't know what I would have done, you know, to not have a supportive family. I don't know how that feels, and I'm blessed, but I know everybody doesn't have that blessing. So anyway, 2 weeks goes by, and of course, you know, my mom has been in mommy mode, and she comes and gets me from my apartment, and we go to the doctor, and she, you know, she confirmed it. She was like, yeah, you do. She was like, you have systemic lupus. And of course, you know, she's super kind, like, we're going to fight this. And at the time, I was on a pretty high dose of prednisone because everything was so bad. Like I said, my kidney functioning was horrible. She was like, you have the function of somebody who should be on dialysis. I don't know if she said it was like every day or every couple of days. Like, she was like, it's bad. It was pretty bad. And I could have took me out of here. Had I not gone to the hospital, it could have took me out of here, and we would have never known. So I'm very thankful to be here. Very thankful that at some point I had the common sense to listen to my mama, who does know it all, and go to the doctor and, you know, get the ball rolling, because most people that are diagnosed keep going to their PCP and getting different testing. Other people I've known who have had lupus, it took them months, maybe like a year, to get diagnosed. So to get diagnosed pretty much within 4 days of a hospital stay was a blessing, and I don't take that lightly. I was given a pretty high dosage of prednisone at the time. She gave me naproxen to deal with the pain. She wanted me to kind of wean myself off of Tylenol, since I had inflamed my stomach at the same time. And I was given Plaquenil. Plaquenil used to treat malaria, but for some reason it works really well for lupus patients, and I've been on that since I was diagnosed. After about a year and a half, so that was about last December, I was finally able to wean off of Plaquenil. Because I begged my rheumatologist to take me off of it, because Plaquenil is a steroid, and all it does is make me hungry. I don't know. I know it works, because like I said, I was on it by itself for about 2 weeks after I left the hospital. She didn't prescribe me Plaquenil when we left. She wanted to wait until I was diagnosed. But the prednisone really, it helped. It did help. So it helped with the alleviate the pain a lot, and so did the naproxen. But baby, that thing makes you hungry. I ballooned. I promise you, I was a good 210, 220. I was 220 at my highest. Literally, I went from a college, I think right after college, maybe grad school, I'll say I might have been about 175, 180, 220. And it's crazy, because it wasn't that I wasn't working out. You're just hungry. Like, you could just eat and just be like, oh my God, Cheetos, come hither. Like, you're just hungry. And I begged my rheumatologist. I was like, please take me off of this drug. So she weaned me off of it, because I tried to quit it cold turkey thinking that I was a G. I got scolded by my rheumatologist and my mama. So that wasn't a good look. So I got back on it. And then I weaned myself off of it as suggested. So I'm not on that. I am on Plaquenil. I am also now on a vitamin D. So that leads me to symptoms. Now, I said earlier that depending on which lupus you have, that's going to judge what your symptoms might be. With me with SLE, I have joint pain. It can affect my organs, but I haven't had any issues with that. since my levels have been really good, but I do have high sensitivity to the sun now. I was a sun baby. If you know my family, you know we vacation a lot. We're always on a cruise going somewhere. In the past 2 years, when we've gone on cruises, the first year we went, I got severely ill. The day after the first day we went to the beach, I was dizzy. It was really bad. I felt like my whole body was shutting down. So the second year, you know, my mama stepped in and had something to say. So I have every straw hat in America. I also have a portable AC. I have I think it's called a frog talk. So it helps, you wet it and it'll pretty much stay cool the whole day. So I usually put it around my neck, put it around my body. If we're gonna be in the heat for a very long time. I started wearing sunscreen, never wore that before in my life, but I do now. I even buy makeup that has SPF in it just because it does not block the sun like the hats and everything do, but it does help a lot. For me, it does. It stops me getting the headaches and things like that. So my sensitivity to sun is crazy. I just got a new car and I had to get tint on it because when I was riding my Altima, and it was black leather seats in my Altima. So, I mean, if I park it in the sun and I get back in the car and the sun is just it was like a sickness that I just, my whole day would be ruined. I can go out, run outside for 10 minutes and my whole day was over. I would just get so ill. I am anemic now. I really wasn't anemic before, but I have tested multiple times since being diagnosed as being anemic now. And that's pretty much my symptoms. And as far as my outlook on life now, I will say that I don't take life for granted as much as I used to. And not that I didn't take life for granted, but I just did not think I was blessed. I'll be honest with you. I have had some really hard moments in life. Things that other people may think was trivial, but it was a big deal to me. Going through stuff in college. Like I said earlier in the video, I had some mental health issues for sure, depression and anxiety. Me going through this experience has definitely made me feel like I just cannot take life for granted. Facing a moment where you feel like basically you were told if you didn't make a different choice, you wouldn't be here. I don't take that for granted. I truly believe God has me here for a reason and there is a purpose for my life. And I also feel like this has opened up my awareness that you do need to tell your story. You do need to talk about these things, especially in the African-American community. We don't talk about stuff. Like I said, even now, people who were praying for me in my grandmother's church probably don't know some of the details that I'm sharing now. And I was following my diagnosis and everything, I was extremely private about it. I really did not want to talk about it because I have had such bad experiences with me telling people things about myself and them running and telling my business or even sadder than that, making fun of it. There are things that happen in life to make you feel let me keep my bubble, you know, but this story is bigger than me. There are stories of lupus on YouTube. I've seen them. But I feel like it doesn't hurt to add that, you know, this illness is not going anywhere. And most importantly, there's still so much unknown about this illness. It is scary to me that this is attacking my population as a black woman. It's sad to me that, like I said, the only thing I knew about lupus previously to being diagnosed was that Toni Braxton had it. We need to know more about this disease. I truly believe that there's a cure out there. I believe there's a cure for cancer. I do, you know, and it breaks my heart because I've lost family members to cancer. I most recently lost my grandfather just last year to liver cancer. And although we know that cancer is preventable, but there are so many other cancers I've seen people going through and fighting. I truly believe there's a cure, and I believe there's a cure for lupus. I feel like there's so much more that we can know about this disease. Like I mentioned earlier, there's neonatal lupus. I shouldn't be fearful to have children, but I am because there's so much unknown about this disease. I am terrified that I'm going to pass that on to my child. And it is something that my partner and I have talked about. And, you know, of course, he's extremely supportive, you know, but I'm nervous because I don't know how that's going to feel if my child is diagnosed and I'm looking at them like, I did this to you. It sucks. It's a feeling that sucks, but, you know, I can only deal with that if it happens. I'm not going to dwell on negativity. I'm going to speak positive thoughts about that and that I'm going to have healthy, happy babies. But this disease is scary. There does need to be more awareness about it. So that being said, I have put some links below in my description bar, and I encourage you all to check it out. If you are a lupus survivor, let me know in the comments. I would love to hear your story or your thoughts on it. If you want to private message me on any of my social media, I think I've opened them all up now. Feel free. It's definitely a safe haven if you just need somebody to talk to, because I've been there. And I know how it feels to walk around with a disease that people don't understand or say cruel things about. And that's another thing, too, that I really would love to bring awareness about, is that you don't know what somebody is going through just because they look a specific way. I've already had a coworker say rude things to me. Like, for example, when I was, I had a flare-up. This was after I was diagnosed. I had a flare-up. It wasn't enough for me because again, I'm a hustler, so I went to work limping it all. I had a handicap sticker. When it gets really bad, my rheumatologist will give me like a 6-month handicap pass, because I really don't want to get a permanent one, because I just don't want to speak that over myself that I will be handicapped. I don't want to speak that over myself, but I do. If it is a situation where I am extremely in pain and it's been a while, I will go get a handicap. But I have had people stare at me oddly if I park in a handicap, just because I am doing my best to walk upright and all that. You don't know what's going on in my body. A little bit, like I said, sometimes, not that I would wish this on myself, but I almost feel like sometimes I wish I had something that people could see, because the things that people say, I've had a coworker say to me, oh, you must have got some bad stuff, meaning I had like rough sex or something the night before. No, lady, I'm mid flare up. Everything hurts and I am here and I'm trying to smile and I'm trying to be positive, and you saying stuff like that's rude. Like, you don't know what's going on with somebody. And of course, when she, I didn't tell her, but I think, well, we were Facebook friends at the time, I think, and I had posted something or something, and so she knew and she came back and apologized. But I've also had people say so many positive things about me, like my boss and some of my other coworkers are like, girl, you are so strong. Like, I don't know how. One of my close coworkers was like, I could see it in your face. Like, but you here and you fighting, and that's the important part. And I have a very supportive family, like I said, who, you know, I'm very blessed to have a mother that I'm very close to. And it's crazy how connected we are, because I don't even have to tell her if I'm not feeling well. She could just, I guess it's a mom thing. Maybe I'll find out one day. But she can just tell, like, oh, my baby is not. She's not here. And my mom and my sister. My sister will come by and help me clean my house. Yeah, I got a 3-story house. And she'll clean it. And she won't complain. And I'm very blessed. Very, very blessed. I have a mom where I could just send her a text and say, I'm not feeling well. My mama will leave work, come to the doctor with me, come over and cook me dinner. I'm very blessed. And my partner, he's not here right now, like I said in another video, but you know, anything I ask him to do, he will do for me. And I'm very blessed to have those type of people in my life. My family, my aunties, you know, they're so supportive. My other auntie will come and get my dog too, and my other auntie will make sure I'm all right and looking fly. And my grandma too, and my grandfather too when he was here. You know, I'm very blessed. Very, very blessed. And I realize that everybody does not have that kind of a support system. But we should. And so I am opening up, like I said, my DMs or private messages. If you have questions or anything you would like to talk about, I am free. I'm here. It can be confidential, because I understand that everybody's not at that place. I've been diagnosed for almost 2 years, and this is the first time I've opened up about some of the hard stuff. And I know this was a long video, but I really wanted to tell my story, because it may be beneficial for somebody. And moving forward, I may vlog a little bit. I can't promise I will vlog during a flare-up, because I don't feel good. I don't feel great. But I don't know. I won't say I wouldn't, but I can't say I will either, because it's not a moment that you want to always share. But I don't know. I'm not going to say no. I may try to vlog something, like when I go to a doctor's visit and how that's like, the kind of routine things that my rheumatologist does, and you know, the blood test that she takes, where she checks my disease levels to see if things are elevated, see if there's something we need to catch. Because if you can catch it, like if something bad happens, like if something happens with my kidneys, we were monitoring my kidneys for a while, so if something happens like that, we try to catch it, which is why they monitor it. I may vlog those things like that. But yeah, but anyway, thank you for sitting through this video. I know it was a long one. I appreciate you guys hearing my story. I pray that it blesses someone. And yeah, I'm out. Bye.